Okay, this is the blood supply of the internal capsule. You can see here that is a part of circle of Willis, and this is the basilar artery divided into posterior cerebral arteries and posterior cerebral arteries, and the internal carotid artery are connected by the posterior communicating branch. And next, the internal carotid artery also gives the middle cerebral artery and also the anterior cerebral artery, and here is the communicating branch, anterior communicating. And also we know that the middle cerebral artery gives the choroidal artery, and this is a part of circle of Willis. Now coming to the internal capsule. Internal capsule is divided into anterior limb, genu, posterior limb, sublentiform and retrolentiform parts. And now coming to the blood supply of these parts. Blood supply of these parts is supplied partly by the internal internal carotid artery and partly by the basilar artery and its branches, and mainly by the circle of Willis. Now from anterior to posterior, anterior limb is supplied by the recurrent artery of Huebner. It is a branch of anterior cerebral artery. It arises just proximal to the anterior communicating branch. So it divides to supply the anterior limb and a part of genu also. Now coming to the genu. Genu is supplied by recurrent artery of Huebner, as we said, and also from the internal carotid artery. A branch from internal carotid artery, central branch, which also supplies the genu. Next, posterior limb. This posterior limb is supplied by the middle cerebral artery. There are two branches, medial striate branches and lateral striate branches. Lateral striate branches is more prone to the ischemic damage, so it is called as artery of cerebral hemorrhage, which is also called as Charcot's artery. Next, coming to sublentiform part. Sublentiform is supplied by the posterior cerebral artery, a branch from the posterior cerebral artery, and also from the choroidal artery. Anterior choroidal artery gives a branch which supplies the sublentiform. So sublentiform is supplied by these two arteries, from the posterior cerebral and anterior choroidal artery. And next, coming to retrolentiform. Retrolentiform part is also supplied by the branch from the posterior cerebral artery. So this is the arterial supply of the internal capsule.